What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? It's your boy Nurse Bass back with another video, and this is the final video in our video series on mastering ABGs. Again, paid for and sponsored by YouTube to help you guys not only crush those ABG exams, but to help you better take care of your patients once you hit the floors.
Are you listening?
Nurse Bass. Beast mode.
So guys, we're at the end of the road. We have discussed a lot, and I just wanted to summarize for you guys everything that we've talked about. So, again, what is an ABG? It stands for arterial blood gas, and it's a tool that we use in healthcare to better assess a patient's respiratory and metabolic status. We've talked about how our lungs help regulate our CO2 levels in our body. We've talked about how our kidneys help regulate the bicarbonate levels in our body. All in a homeostatic acid-based balance to maintain a homeostatic blood pH. We've talked about how CO2 is an acid and how bicarbonate is a base, how our normal CO2 levels are 35 to 45, bicarbonate is 22 to 26, and again, they work in perfect balance to maintain a blood pH of 7.35 to 7.45. Not forgetting why it's so important that we maintain that homeostatic balance of blood pH. Because once you begin to become too acidotic, below 7.35, or too alkalinic, above 7.45, that's whenever proteins begin to denature. That's whenever cells begin to die. And don't forget, blood, we're talking about blood pH, blood perfuses every organ and tissue and cell in your body. And so what we're doing is we're creating an environment that is unsuitable for life. So it's very important that we maintain that nice 7.35 to 7.45. We've talked about the tic-tac-toe method and how we use that to solve arterial blood gas problems and how it's not always so simple and direct and clear cut to see that this is definitely metabolic acidosis or that's definitely respiratory alkalosis. But how there's some deviation. And we call this deviation compensation. And again, not only is it reflected in these arterial blood gas results, you'll definitely see them in the questions directly reflected in those results, but also to understand what that compensation means. That our bodies aren't going to just lay down and take it, that we're going to try and compensate for these acidotic or these alkalinic states. And that our body does that via, again, our respiratory and our renal system. And that it is this perfect balance of these acids and these bases that maintain a normal blood pH and therefore sustain life. That is what arterial blood gases are. If you can understand that, if you can understand everything that we've discussed in this video series, you're going to absolutely crush those exams. You're going to have gone above and beyond. And you'll be impressing some professors out there with your knowledge of ABGs. But again, and as I've stated in almost every video, more importantly, whenever you're out there on the floor and you don't have a preceptor holding your hand and teaching you the ropes and it's just you taking care of that patient and you have to get an ABG on that patient, you'll know. You won't even need that tic-tac-toe method to interpret an ABG result. You'll just know immediately what that ABG result means, and you'll know what's going on within that patient's body so that you can help be a better provider for that patient. That's the name of the game, ladies and gentlemen. Never lose sight of that. Even though we're just taking exams and taking questions and doing our best to score as good as we can, never forget what you're doing this for. You're doing it for that patient. Guys, this was Mastering ABGs. Massive, massive thank you to YouTube for this opportunity to provide this kind of education to you guys. I really, truly hope it was helpful. Leave a comment down below if you got some benefit from this. Please share this series with a friend, a cohort, somebody else who is just struggling to grasp this concept. It's been your boy, Nurse Bass. I'll catch you guys in the next video. Peace.